Hello, all you nerds out there in YouTube land. Welcome back to 3MVTA. I am your host, Big Jake, and today I'm going to give you my top 10 movie sequels. Hope you enjoy it. Please like and subscribe, and let's go ahead and get started. Number 10, The Bourne Supremacy, being released in 2004, based on the second of the Bourne trilogy. Of course, now there's like, I think, five Bourne movies, although one of them doesn't have Matt Damon in it. But this one, in my opinion, this is the best of the three movies, honestly, of the original trilogy. Jason Bourne just goes ham on these guys and, you know, just takes care of business. You have, because he finally gets away, and then of course at the beginning of this film they track him down and they try to blame him for an assassination, and they inadvertently end up killing his girlfriend, which sends him over the edge and sends him to go back after these people. So check it out. It's definitely a nice thrill ride that keeps you going, very nicely action-packed, and just very well done. So well, let's move on to number 9. Number 9, The Godfather Part 2. Now, I know you're all thinking probably crazy that this isn't higher on the list, but to be fair, it's just, I love the Godfather movies, I really do, but there's just movies that I enjoy more. You know, I'm not big on, you know, like drama and stuff like that, but, so, which is probably why this is lower on the list, but anyway, I put this movie on here. Despite, in my opinion, it's hard to say if it's superior to the original film, but it's just, it gives you so much. And, you know, we get to see Don Corleone as a young man growing up, being played by Robert De Niro. You know, and in this one, Michael has already, you know, taken over the family and is, you know, doing what he wants to do with it, following in his father's footsteps. So obviously, I'm sure most people listening to this have seen this movie, so I don't think I really need to go into too much detail with it. So we'll go ahead and go on to number 8. Number 8, Dawn of the Dead, by George A. Romero, being released in 1978. This was just an amazing sequel film. In my opinion, I think it's better than Night of the Living Dead in a lot of aspects. For one thing, it's in color, and of course, being a spoiled kid of my generation, you know, we're all about colored films. And it's just that, you know, this was a great movie, a great satire on, you know, day-to-day life. You know, this was made in a time when, hence how the movie takes place in a mall. This was made in a time when malls were popping up all over America, and that was the point, the idea, that was part of the point that George A. Romero was making, a point that, you know, we were becoming zombies and as consumers and going to these malls and just shopping and wasting our money and wasting our lives. And so, yeah, that's a pretty neat little, you know, metaphor for, you know, the flesh-eating zombie flick. So, and we'll go on to number 7. Number 7, The Bride of Frankenstein. Absolutely phenomenal film, being released in 1935. James Whale really hit the nail on the head with this. You know, you have the monster and one of the best villains of all time, Dr. Pretorius, being played by Ernest Thesinger, who's just, you know, an evil, you know, like an evil mad scientist doctor, like you see in cheesy movies from back in the day, but it's just, he's so good. And, you know, of course you have the bride, and it's just the way, you know, the way the film does, it's, they, you know, this is where where the monster learns to talk, and, he learns to like the things in life, like cigars and brandy and that kind of thing. So just a really good, really fun film. With it only being 75 minutes long, you know, you should definitely give it a watch. So we'll move on to number 6. Number six, A Nightmare on Elm Street 3, The Dream Warriors. A lot of people think that this is the best film of the franchise. I would say that's pretty darn close. In all reality, it's definitely the best sequel, I would think. Freddy returning, you know, for the third time, of course. And in this one, you get these group of kids that in their dreams they learn to control their dreams, and they all have these like powers and cool abilities, and of course, you know, Freddy of course still picks them off all one by one. But definitely an awesome 80s movie. You got the amazing Dokken song, Dream Warriors, and it's just an all-around fun, good horror flick. Number six, I picked Blade 2, coming out in 2002. Also being done by Guillermo del Toro. Blade 2 is when Blade is actually asked, by vampires, aka his, you know, enemies, to help hunt down these new breed of vampires that actually feed on other vampires. The main villain being played by Luke Goss, Nomak, is just this monster of a, you know, powerful vampire creature. He's unbelievably strong, and the ending fight scene in this film between Blade and Nomak is absolutely awesome. So honestly, it's definitely better than the ending fight scene between this and Blade Trinity, where he fights quote-unquote Dracula, and the fight scene's really not all that good. But we'll go ahead and move on to number six, Lord of the Rings, The Two Towers. I put this in here because, I mean, despite the fact that The Lord of the Rings is just an epic trilogy of films, some of the best films, honestly, even to this, even being early as, you know, being done as late as 2002, they're considered some of the best films of all time. They have amazing acting, amazing effects. They did Peter Jackson did a really good job of being, you know, fairly faithful to the source material with a few changes here and there, you know. And this, you know, when you have the fighting trees, and then on top of that, you have the surge of Helm's Deep. But the surge of Helm's Deep, like I was saying before, sorry for the interruption, my son was yelling at me, is just an amazingly epic fight battle scene. It's honestly, the surge of Helm's Deep is my favorite, like, big battle scene of all the three movies. It's just so well done, so good. They do a great job with the tension and the atmosphere and the hopelessness, and then here comes, you know, at the end, here comes the hope, and, you know, and it's it's just so well done. It really is. Peter Jackson outdid himself with this franchise, so. But we'll go ahead and move on to number five. Number five, The Dark Knight, the Christopher Nolan Batman trilogy. I mean, this movie is still talked about to this day, not just because, you know, Heath Ledger passed away, but just how well done the Joker was. His performance as the Joker is going to go down in movie history, and it already has, you know. And this film just keeps going with, you know, with people like people like me and others who are comic book fans and see the Joker acting like the Joker, you know, he's this crazy but calculating supervillain who just doesn't care. He's gonna do what he wants to do. He doesn't care. And, you know, I mean, Alfred in this film hit the nail on the head. Sometimes, you know, villains just want to be villains for villains' sake. You know, with the phrase, you know, sometimes men just want to watch the world burn, and then, you know, there's no reasoning with them, there's no bargaining with them, there's nothing you can do. That, you know, the Joker is a villain for villains' sake, although he is, you know, insane. So, number four. The Devil's Rejects, a follow-up to House of a Thousand Corpses, and in my opinion, far superior to House of a Thousand Corpses. Now, I understand that they were done completely different styles. Why it is the superior film is since it's not done the same way in the same style. It's kind of hard to compare the two in that sense by saying that this is just, you know, seeing it superior, you know, just because it's not done the same way. It's not the same style of film. You know, House of a Thousand Corpses was done in an old school slasher, gritty horror movie style, whereas this is done, you know, in like, it's done in a lot more. I'm trying to think of the word for it. He did this in a sense that, you know, because it's from the perspective of the villains, basically. And it follows them around, and, you know, and they're not, you know, it's not about people getting picked off one by one, and it's not, you know, it doesn't have the slow tension or any of that stuff. So, and, you know, Bill Moseley does an amazing, absolutely over-the-top job as Otis. William Forsythe does a shining part here as the sheriff getting revenge for his brother that was killed by Otis. And fun fact, one of my favorite comedians, funny man Brian Posehn, does a cameo in this film and then gets shot in the head. So that's pretty fun. We'll move on to number three. Number three, I picked Halloween 2018. Now this is actually has two films tied for number three, but either one's not necessarily above the other one. But Halloween 2018, I picked this film. I saw this film in the theaters with my wife. And, frankly, was kind of blown away. I thought they did such a good job. You know, they went the same way as, a lot of people don't understand this. There's that movie that's just called, the name of the film is just called Texas Chainsaw. It's a sequel to the Texas Chainsaw Massacre movie franchise. But what it did was it takes place, similar to this film, it takes place way in the future and completely ignores all the other sequels. So in essence, it's its whole new line of films. This one does the same thing. This one is a direct sequel to the first film, ignoring all other sequels. And it, you know, takes place 40 years later, and it's just, I thought it was awesome. The tension's good. The kills are great. Michael is still this creepy, supernatural monster of a human being, you know, of a killer. And it's just Jamie Lee Curtis coming back again to play Laurie Strode was, I think, a good move. She does a great job as this old paranoid, you know, waiting for him to come back kind of character. And, you know, if you haven't, for whatever reason, if you haven't seen this film, see it. It was very well done, very well good, or very well written and everything else. And it started its own line of sequels with, you know, Halloween Kills of already being released, and the newest one coming up this year, which I do plan to go see in the theaters. So also at number three, we have Halloween 2, the sequel to John Carpenter's film. This one was not directed by John Carpenter, however, but him and Deborah Hill did write it. And it's just a direct sequel to John Carpenter's first Halloween movie. And it was just a good, solid sequel film. I mean, a sequel to such a low budget, you know, the original Halloween was so low budget, and did was so amazing. And here, you know, the film takes place on the same night, directly picks up where the first one left off. I thought that was a really, really good choice. And it's just, you know, I do think it would have been better if John Carpenter had directed it. The film probably would have ended up as a better film overall. But in that sense, it's still very well done. I'm sure everybody has seen this film. And so I won't spend too much time on it. But we'll go ahead and move on to number two. Number two, Terminator 2 Judgment Day. And yeah, I put this on here because, I mean, it's just, honestly, in my opinion, it surpasses the original Terminator. One of the few sequels that are better than the original film. And honestly, my number one and number two pick could have been either or as far as, in my opinion, the best sequels of all time. It's just that good. You got Arnold back as the Terminator, of course, and just, you know, it's an nonstop action, keeps you guessing. Keeps the tension up about when the T-1000 is going to strike again. Who does he look like? What is he? You know, and it's just absolutely phenomenally done. Amazing film. I'm sure everybody has seen it. And we'll move on to number one. Well, anybody who's seen any of my films, any of my videos before, probably could have seen this coming, but Aliens. Aliens is an amazing film. Absolutely amazingly. Everything about it is good. The writing, the directing, the special effects, the creatures, the acting is awesome. It has comedy, it has sadness, it has, you know, that claustrophobic killer sense to it, similar to the first movie, but obviously done on a different scale, because, you know, the first movie had like a noir slasher kind of vibe to it, whereas this one is, you know, it's action, 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 and then you have that claustrophobic tension of being stuck in the base waiting for rescue and all that jazz. Just, and once again, I think this is a sequel that, in my opinion, surpassed the original film. Now, just like with The Devil's Rejects, since its style is completely different, you can't do a one-on-one comparison, but I do think that Aliens is the better film. Now, I will say, I think the movie Alien is better done in the sense of how the film was done, but as far as overall superiority, I think the Aliens just hit the nail on the head. To this day, still remains one of my favorite movies of all time. And let's hope that, since we're once again going to get apparently some more Alien movies, let's just hope they're better than the last few that we got. You know, I really hope that for all of us out there. So, but that's it, guys. Thanks for watching. I hope everybody enjoyed this video about movie sequels. Hopefully some of these are some of your favorites. I would love to hear your comments, or see your comments below, rather. And tell me what you think. Are any of these any of your favorites? Is there any sequel films out there that maybe I didn't think of? And then if so, I would love to hear your comments about it down below. But next time on our channel, I'm going to be ranking the Dragon Ball franchise movies. Now, only the ones I've seen. There are a couple I haven't seen yet, and I will admit that. But all the Dragon Ball movie franchises that I have seen, I'll be ranking all of them from worst to best. So, for everybody out there, I'll see you guys. Same nerd time, same nerd channel. Have a good evening.